you know, 2005 for 7,000.
Yo, people. This is Dragon Lord Frodo here.
Live session. Cool.
Yeah, we're filming this tonight.
Even though it's only noon.
Even though it's only noon. This is a road trip, yo. Oh. A road trip. Look where we are. Look where we are. Ooh. A+. Sunoco.
You print out stuff like the chick on the iPad.
Yeah.
Turn left onto Ridge Road.
Ooh, a Walgreens.
Turning onto Ridge Road. Hey, look at those cool leaves. The red and the
yellow. Here, I'll get the leaves. Cool. Where's the... Ooh.
Right there.
I see them. I got them.
Those are cool.
I'm getting them on tape.
Over here, too. They got red and green mixed on the corner there by that white, where that trailer hits.
It's not actual tape, is it? It's digital.
It's like it's like I'm hard driving it or something. Mm-mm. I'm taping it. Oh. Rent a center. That's when we know we're in the ghetto.
Can you watch the lights for me?
I can.
So yeah, we're going on a trip to an unknown place. Oh, maybe I should flip this around and say we're on a trip to an unknown
location.
Only known to me and the two other people in this vehicle.
Good job.
So, you kiddies don't know yet, but what?
Could be laughing all the way there. She's not used to you.
Really?
I like when you said you kiddies.
Yeah, because I'm talking to the people that watch this crap.
Oh, okay.
I'm talking to the morons that watch my YouTube videos.
Quarters of a mile, take a slight right turn to merge onto
I-90
East.
What do you say?
In 3/4 mile, take a slight right to merge onto 1 I-90 East.
Oh.
I got the list of steps up so I can read it to you, Michael, if we need.
Yeah.
Every once in a while, just show them the map. If you'll record the map.
The map.
Are you still going for Eats with your rich uncle?
Yeah.
There you go. Where are you going?
We're going to the Como tomorrow.
The Homo?
Yeah, the Como Homo.
We went there for Don's husband's funeral breakfast.
Really?
Yeah.
What'd they have there? Just like spaghetti?
Yep,
no. I got the map. What'd they get? What'd you get? Like a spaghetti or something?
Yeah, they've got spaghetti, they had chicken, and meatball.
Meat the ball?
Meat the ball.
I might get a lasagna while I'm there.
What else?
Huh?
What else?
We mean what else?
You can't just have one thing when you're there.
I might have like some garlic bread too.
Yeah, but I'm sure you gotta get like a turkey or something.
I don't want a turkey. I don't eat turkey. It's too healthy.
Miss Pan Pinto just... healthy?
Yeah, turkey. Isn't turkey kind of healthy?
Well, it's... Pretty much anything that you don't eat is healthy.
Really?
Anything you do eat...
Okay. You know, I found a... I invented a way to lose weight. You know, and it actually...
It's working so well, as we can see.
Well, I just started doing it.
Okay.
And I actually found it on accident.
How's this one? How are you making your millions off it? You're gonna have an infomercial?
No, I'm not making money off it. I'm making like me skinny with it.
Okay, how are you gonna do this?
Okay, what you do? Okay, you can eat whatever you want. Okay, but the thing is that you gotta get
You gotta go to a grocery store and get the hottest hot sauce you can find, okay? Okay? You with me? So, I guess the hottest hot sauce you can find is called Scorpion Pepper Hot Sauce. But Ghost Pepper Sauce will work as well. Mm-hmm. Okay? You with me?
You don't have to say that every couple of seconds.
Yep, we're with you.
Okay. So, you make whatever you want, but you put some of that hot sauce on it, okay?
Right.
Now, with the Ghost Pepper and the Scorpion Pepper sauces, that'll burn your mouth faster than, you know, you'll be like, you'll take two or three bites and like, you can't even take it anymore, okay? Now, this lasts for about 15 minutes, the heat. So what you do is you gotta go up and get water, okay? So what you're doing is you eat a little bit of food with the hot sauce on it, and then you go and chug water to relieve it. Now, while you're chugging the water, it'll fill you up. And by the time that you're relieved from the heat, you're like, I don't even want to eat anymore because I'm so full on water.
Okay.
You know, so
why don't you just drink a lot of water, save all the other processes, and be done?
I mean, you can do that too, but the hot sauce kind of forces you to drink all kinds of water.
Yeah, but you do realize that there's no nutritional value in water, so in a couple of months, or a couple of weeks possibly, you'll be so malnutritioned that you'll be in the hospital and you'll be getting fed by a tube in your arm.
Well, I guess, but, you know, that you know, you're not, you know, you don't have, from what I understand, you don't have to eat a whole lot to you know, be new, what is it?
Well,
you don't have to eat like a
balanced diet in order to be properly nutritioned.
You don't have to eat that much, though.
No, but you have, what you eat has to be a proper. This is the person to talk to. She's the nutritionist.
Yeah.
You have to
say that again, Eddie.
He said that you don't have to eat a lot to be properly nutritioned.
Like I guess like the.
Nope, you got that the opposite.
What, you don't
properly nutrition. If you went on the nutrition chart that they have in the doctor's offices.
Yeah.
And all that, where it tells you all your square meals a day, all your calorie intakes.
Squares.
Everything you're supposed to. It's called a food pyramid.
Yeah.
They call it, and they have it in all the cafeterias at kids' schools and doctor's offices.
Yeah.
You have to eat like 4 servings of greens in a day to get the proper allowance.
Yeah.
Of the certain vitamin that you need just from greens. Then you have to eat so many servings. And this is daily. So many servings of either, which is dairy, which could be milk, cheese,
yeah,
yogurt.
Did you ever hear something
like that?
That's on a lot of food
protein
packaging?
Is fish, eggs.
Did you ever hear something on most food packaging that says USDA requirements?
Yeah.
Nutritional facts?
USDA is United States Daily Requirements. That's the amount that you need to be properly nutritioned. So you would remain healthy.
Wait, what does that stand for?
USDA, United States Daily Allotment.
I thought it was United States Department of Agriculture.
No, that's Department of Agriculture of the USDA.
Right.
And that's also.
And that's also part of the things with, because that.
But it's issued by them.
Right.
No, it's with government, everything's in an acronym.
And they have everything.
They love initials.
Yep. And they have everything down to kilometers and micrometers and milligrams, kilograms.
They're not metering because that's a distance.
Okay.
They're not metering.
You don't have to eat 5 feet of
ounces.
I can eat 5 foot of sub.
Well, you could, and that would actually be unhealthy for you.
Yeah, probably. If it was a Subway sub, then it'd be all right.
Even if it was a Subway sub and it was 5 feet long, it would still be unhealthy for you because you would not be getting your daily allowance of all your intake for everything for a full balanced diet.
Much more of certain things and not enough of other things.
Exactly.
I guess.
Your body needs a little bit of everything.
Yeah. Like the reason that like I lost my hair is when I had my stomach surgery.
Yeah.
I was missing a. Remember when I had my stomach surgery? I still had my hair.
Yeah.
And then after that, it started thinning out.
You were always thinning out.
What's that?
You were always thinning out.
My hair was always fine until I had the stomach surgery.
I don't know. I mean, it runs in the family.
But I can show you the pictures.
Grandpa lost his hair. Grandma. My mom. I'm losing my hair.
And I'm laughing at you because you always used to make fun of me. Now I can sit here and rub your head and make a wish.
Mark's losing his hair.
Mark's lost his hair 25 years ago.
Yeah. Now he just has like a little crown or whatever.
If you look at my student ID pictures,
yeah.
Look at me 2 months before I had the stomach surgery, I had full hair.
Yeah.
You look at my UV picture, which was 5 months after my surgery,
yeah.
And my hair was way thin.
Wow.
But I lost 308 pounds, so
yeah.
I added about 10 years to my life, so I guess hair is a...
Yeah, you can grow back hair. That's no problem. You can wear a wig or something.
I'm not wearing a wig. I think I am bald.
Yeah, they have certain things on there. Water is something that can sustain you to keep you alive in an emergency situation.
Yeah.
As well as it also being something that you need daily.
Yeah.
To hydrate yourself and to flush your system out.
Yeah.
Now, if you're eating only certain foods and you eat a 5 foot sub, okay, and you drink a 2 liter of soda.
Yeah.
Easy.
Okay. You're getting high amount of sugar.
Yeah.
High amount of glucose and certain dyes.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't really drink pop that much.
You stopped drinking pop, didn't you?
You drink a lot of water now.
Yeah. Okay. I sometimes drink.
Totally
but
stop,
even but still, yeah. Do you realize that a person that drinks...
You used to drink a 2 liter sitting at Mark's house.
Oh, yeah.
You know, a person can actually drink too much water.
Yeah.
And their body starts to retain water. And you're probably going to say, how's that possible, right? When you're eating your sub or your pizza from wherever you purchase it from, and you're eating chicken wings and everything else... Even though you don't add salt to it, a lot of foods have salt in them as a preservative. Inside.
Yeah.
That's why vegetables, they tell you, if you buy them in a can, rinse them out.
He's like both you and Don. He adds salt like it's on style.
So salt builds water in your system and makes you retain water. But salt also dehydrates you.
Yeah.
Salt also... can bring up your sodium level.
Yeah,
which, that's because salt is sodium. So right. Which person can bring up your level?
That can cause heart problems.
Yeah.
And then the amount of fat intake that you eat is not like just grabbing like a scoop of lard out of a container and eating it.
I do that. Right. No, I don't.
But I'm talking fat intake, meaning...
It's not like tasting the lipstick.
The oil that they cook it in.
At the makeup counter.
Well, hold on, say it again. I got to get that on tape. I got to get that...
Topping that they put, the sauce or whatever.
Yeah, what about eating lipstick?
It's not like you eating lipstick and trying to taste it at the lipstick counter at JCPenney's.
That's cute.
I don't know what that means.
You don't know what it means, but you did it.
No, there was something at, what's that place called?
Euphoria.
Sephora, that's what it's called.
Sephora, you told me that there's like chocolate chip lipstick or chocolate chip lip gloss, and you wanted to taste it to see if it actually tasted.
No. What it was, it wasn't lipstick. It was like hand lotion. Oh. It was like hand lotion or whatever. And it said on the.
All right, we gotta quiet down for a minute. So we can
all right, pass. Border Patrol. All right.
Just turn on
Border Patrol.
Yeah, 50.1 miles straight.
Okay. I just did the number.
It's 47 to merge onto.
You have anything to declare?
90 toward New York 19, me right.
This isn't border. This is toll.
This isn't border. It's toll.
Oh, yeah, whatever.
Pick up a ticket.
Yeah. They're gonna.
I like you. Further.
Thank you. Have a good day.
What's he doing?
He's playing a game and he's fucking handing me the ticket so I can move instead.
We're going 50 miles, take exit 47 and merge onto I-490 toward.
Yeah, we're just going straight for a round.
Right. Yeah. So
all right, back to Michael. You make
so I can find out.
No, I was. It was. It
find out the toll first, Leroy. It's gonna be $2.
Leroy.
I have no money.
Leroy.
Michael, do you have two singles on you until we get change?
I don't.
Okay. I have no singles.
We gotta go to Leroy. Okay, now eating makeup. What's this about?
You were chomping on the lipstick, the chick stick.
No, it was like hand lotion. It was hand lotion. Yeah.
Well, I'm sure you know well about hand lotion, right?
Right, and then break change when you come on the way home because we'll have another dollar. It'll be $2.
Yeah.
And right on the bottle of the hand. On the bottle of the hand lotion, it said cupcake scented or something.
Oh, cupcake flavor.
Yeah, no, not flavor. Hand lotion is not flavor.
Oh, scented.
That's what it said. It said there was a bunch of them. There was like cupcake scented, chocolate scented, and like strawberry. There's a bunch of them.
Wow.
But I ended up opening it up and smelling it just to see if it's really smell like that. What about the white?
You're good. You got room before the red one behind you.
I don't want to die in a fiery crash. Things. I want to make sure I can find my body, or at least my skeletal.
Your dental records. No, but
I don't want them to have to check my dental records.
No, I think I said on Facebook the one time that I was smelling that hand lotion, and I started getting hungry. But I never actually ate the hand lotion. Because it was smelling like cupcakes and chocolate and, and like...
But you told me that you wanted to taste it to see if it actually tasted...
No, I smelled it.
But you told me you wanted to taste it to see if it actually tasted like it smelled.
I'm sure it does.
I'm sure you tried it. You just put it on film.
I'm serious. I think it might would have tasted like that, but it would just be like a weird texture or something. Like you've ever tried to eat hand lotion?
No, that's not normally on my dietary platter.
Well, I think it would taste kind of like that, like with a little bit of like cupcake in it or something. Seriously, I'd rather just eat a cupcake.
Lotion didn't do it for you, huh?
No, I didn't eat the lotion. The motion lotion.
Are you currently recording?
Yeah.
Can you hold it for a second? Because I want to ask you a question that shouldn't go on.
Okay, here we go. I'm broke.
In Medina.
That's where they make the Yancey's fancy cheese.
It's Pembroke and Vagina.
What is it?
Pembroke and Vagina.
Pembroke and Medina.
It's Vagina.
It's Vagina.
Are we boring you?
should I check? What's this say?
Zacharin and Corfu.
Tofu?
Tofu and acorn.
Acorn. Acorn tofu.
Are you going to your mom's for Thanksgiving?
I don't know what they're doing. There's Yancey's Fancy. Sleep.
Well, I already told Don that we might have to do like we did 2 years ago where we did both.
Dawn.
Here comes Pembroke and Vagina.
Pembroke.
It's actually Pembroke.
What was I saying? Pembroke?
It looks Pembroke. Like Brook, or it said Brook, but it's Broke.
Pembroke.
Because Brook would be...
Pembroke.
Yeah, but Brook would be B-R-O-O-K. It's P-R-B-R-O-K-E, which is Broke.
Yeah.
Why is there a big T-A Is it a truck stop? Isn't it a wrapper TA?
TA? No. I don't know.
TI.
And look at old Glory flying in the breeze.
I think the rapper's name is T-Pain or something.
Gas station. There's so many rappers.
Hamburg Sud.
T-Bag and there's
T-Bag.
T-I. So why are you and Mark on to eat?
Why?
Just to be dudes and hang out?
Yeah, I think my mom's is going too.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. So she's gonna play the referee role. You know what that means, right?
Keep it between you and Mark, yeah.
Huh?
Lots of fun.
Make sure that you and Mark don't get in each other's throats.
No. It's because when you know, like we go to like buffets and stuff and my mom comes, she's like, Mike, you can only eat two plates of food.
We were at a buffet the other day and that's all we were doing is talking about your buffetisms.
Yeah, I ate two plates.
What happened
of food,
to you at Homestyle
that
Buffet?
I was including my desserts and my fruit.
Didn't you get kicked out of Homestyle Buffet or didn't you break a toilet or something like that?
No. That was the Old Country Buffet. Okay. Old Country Buffet, Transit Road near the Eastern Hills Mall. Me and my dad were there or something. Oh, there's a deer. There's roadkill.
We won't look at that.
Let's see, we got
Rochester. Oh, there's more. There's more deer. I'm gonna take a picture of the deer. Slow down. Where's the deer?
Just ran away.
Yeah.
Oh man. I wanna get the deer. So no, it was the Old Country Buffet on Transit Road, okay? Old Country Buffet on Transit Road, okay? What happened was me and my dad were there.
Okay, go ahead.
Me and my dad were there eating. I must have ate way too much there. So, we were about to leave and I had to go use the bathroom in there, right?
It blew it up, didn't you?
And I took a crap in their toilet and I ended up like plugging up their toilet or something. And my dad was waiting for me outside the bathroom and I walk out and I said, Dad, let's go. And he's like, what's the matter? And he's like, let's go. And there was a guy just going in there to clean the bathroom too. I said, I'll explain when we get in the car. And I just said, you know what? I just killed their toilet.
Okay, let me just say this. There's a rest stop coming up here, and the next one's not for 33 miles. Do you need it or not?
Yes, I do.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
Ooh, gift shop.
A gift shop.
Oh, I'd like some roadkill, please.
Whoa, what's in the gift shop? Like chili or something.
No, maybe some Yancey's Fancies.
No.
What is Yancey's Fancies? What is that? Licorice?
Yancey's Fancies.
It's some cheese.
Okay.
It's like they have like
a brand of cheese.
Yeah.
All kinds of different things.
They have like garlic cheese or something. You know what I did the one time? You know near the Boulevard Mall? You ever go to Boulevard Mall?
Yeah, I go by there every day.
Okay, you know that Wegmans that's there? Mm-hmm. I went into that Wegmans, right? And I bought like some like a block of cheese, Yancey's. I think it was like garlic something cheese. And I went across the street to the Boulevard Mall. And you know, I was hungry, so what I did was I just whipped out the cheese and started eating a block of cheese right inside the mall there. That's something I would do, right?
Yeah, they're Yancey Fancies. They're big supporters of the Buffalo Sabres.
Yeah.
Buffalo Bills.
Oh yeah.
More Sabres than Bills.
Yeah, because it's
one of those places where I usually get
been at this week.
Do what he's doing.
What is he doing? Where are we? Yeah. What city are we in?
We're in Pembroke right now.
Oh, Pembroke.
Mm-hmm.
Pembroke.
Yep, we're just before Batavia.
Oh, okay.
Okay, you calm down, honey. Okay, you're gonna go and hit the head.
I'm just gonna click the screen off real quick.
Can we just wait in here?
Yeah, I'm gonna. I'm not going in. Go ahead, young lady.
I clicked the screen off and it's not gonna back on. He doesn't wanna pay attention to me.
I'm gonna park right over here. It's not even a handicap spot, or else I would have to flash my handicap badge.
You would have to get out in a wheelchair or something.
Proceed to the route. Okay. Fuck you. After that, you should just pull. Had one underneath.
What is that, an iPad?
Yeah. You should have just pulled up so you can just pull out then.
Two iPads.
Yes. Yeah, one for her, and one for me.
Yeah.
Just like we have two handicaps. One for her and one for me.
Why is one red and one blue?
Mine's temporary. Hers is permanent.
Oh.
I'll be laid out.
So that way you can get great parking.
Yep. Watch out, lady. This girl's trying to get by.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Let's see.
All right, I'm taping. Want to put on some music? Put on some death metal.
I was trying to. I didn't know if you wanted that to play over your...
As long as it's not too loud. You should play my rock opera.
I don't have it in the car.
Oh, that's too bad. I should have brought it with me.
I have it on iPod 1.
Yeah. Is it something you listen to on a daily basis?
Absolutely not.
Why? Is it that bad?
There's no music.
What do you mean?
It's you running your fingers over a guitar for 45 minutes.
For an hour.
Okay.
Yeah.
That makes it even better?
No, there's melody to it.
There's melody, that's about it. What do you want to hear?
I don't know, what do you have?
Name anything.
I don't know. Pick something good. Put on that Napalm Death you had the other night from Guar or whatever.
No, I got something even tastier.
What's that? What's that, like the Beatles or something?
Let's see if you can handle this.
It better be the heaviest band ever. Is this a Sex Pistols cover song?
No.
Oh, it sounds like it. What is that over there? Is that Darien Lake?
It's the raceway.
Oh, is it? What was that? Lancaster Speedway.
No, it's that Speedway there, right?
Speedway?
Yeah, the raceway over here that we just passed.
Not Lancaster. Oh,
I don't know. Do we pass Darien Lake yet?
Oh, yeah, we're
Oh, okay.
I can't believe it.
We probably passed the chili sign, didn't we?
No, I've been watching for. I wouldn't let you miss Chi Line.
Chili.
Hey, you want to say something in there?
Yeah, you know, that's actually how it's pronounced, too. Chi Line.
Yeah, that's why.
I thought you were just, I thought you were just being a jerk when you said that, like that, or whatever. No, because I heard it on the news once. They said Chi Lai on the news. They said Chi Lai on the news like that.
N-A-P-A-L-M. Death. The word death.
Death. Yeah, they actually said, because I heard it on the news, they said Chi Lai on the news. I'm like, what? That's actually said like that? I thought you were just playing around.
We'll listen to some Scum.
Scum. That's a good album.
That's one of my favorites.
That's grindcore right there. You know why they call it grindcore?
Because of that. Momentum of the music.
It's because
it grinds against the beat.
Well, no, it's more because the songs are real short and there's a lot of them, so they're kind of like grinding out the songs or something.
Kind of like Grindhouse movies?
Yeah, because they exactly, because they're grinding out movies left and right or something.
I love the Grindhouse movies. You've seen them, right?
Yeah.
I took Paris to listen.
Who's Harris?
I've seen the Grindhouse movies on my own.
Who's Paris?
A girl I used to work with at
Paris Hilton.
Yeah, she used to work at Bank of America.
Yeah.
Because she doesn't have enough money. She figured she could make $16.50 an hour and add to her billions of dollars.
Oh, look what it is. Look what's over there. It's Dix. There's a Dix over there.
We're at Batavia.
We're at Batavia.
I think after Batavia is Chili.
Why'd they name a city after? Where's the Dix? I gotta get the picture of the Dix. Home Depot. Why'd they name it? Oh, I'll get the Dix sign there.
Because it's the guy's name.
What?
Oh, why do you name it Chili?
Yeah. What's a Chi Lai?
Chi Lai is Spanish for cold.
Oh, is it? Oh. No, that's fresco or something. I don't know.
Depends on what. It's not Spanish, it's Puerto Rican.
Portuguese or something.
No,
or
Puerto Rican.
Puerto Rico. Yeah, say it right. Well, that's why they say it like that? That's, I don't know. We gotta look that one up. there's also another city, I think it's around here, it's called Java, but it's a Java or something. I bet you that's the same makers of Chi Lai.
Because if the line above the A, if it would go to the right, it would be Java.
What?
But the line above the A goes to the left, so it's Java.
Oh, it's the accent mark.
Accent grave. Accent grave, accent du.
Yeah. Did you know like those two dots above a thing, it's called an omelet or something?
Omelet.
And you know the band Green Jello?
Yep.
Well, you know the band.
It's not Jello anymore.
No, it's green, it's spelled like green jelly, but because it has those two dots, I guess you gotta pronounce it Jello still.
Right, but as long as they don't spell it with the O, they're not breaking the copyright.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what
That's what Bill Manspeaker told me. You know who that is, right? He's a guy that does that whole green jelly, green jello thing. I'm actually friends with him on Facebook. It's actually him too. He wanted to sell me.
How do you know?
What?
How do you know it's actually him?
I know.
How?
I was talking to him on the messenger.
But how do you know it's him though?
Okay, I don't. But you know, if I were to go to one, I'm sure if I went to one of his shows one of these days.
It probably is him. He's not that big to where he wouldn't have his own message board.
Yeah. I mean, like, I'm sure if I went to one of his shows, he'd probably recognize me by the pics or something. Yeah, the guy from Green Jello recognizes me. But yeah, I mean, he was trying to, like, sell me a puppet or something? No, it's like one of those puppets that they use in a show. What's this? But he wanted, like, $200 for it. I'm like, screw that. He wanted to sell me a bass too. It was like a bass with a like this. What's this song called? Like, ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah.
It's,
that's what I want. That's my dream jacket. I would love to have a chain jacket.
Is that real leather?
Yeah.
Yeah. You should get a pleather jacket.
This is a fall and winter one, too. Woman's fringe black leather jacket. 11 carats.
Oh, look at all the corn. I'm taking pictures.
Huh? All feeder corn. You can't eat that corn.
Why?
It's not, you get sick on it. It's
why?
Stuff they feed the animals with.
They don't get sick on it? Why?
There's a whole bunch of corn.
It's animal feed.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of corn that's growing.
It's got certain growth stuff in it.
Yeah. They you know, like, they spray stuff over in that.
Yeah.
They make it specifically to feed the the cows and all the farm animals.
Yeah.
And you would actually get sick because all the hormones in there, they're not meant for human consumption.
Oh yeah. They're unfit for
human. So if you went up there and started gnawing on a piece of corn, you'd be barfing up probably a lung or something.
That might be like barfing up Sun Chips. In my mom's toilet or something. Remember that time?
Yeah. You're staying at the rent spot?
Yeah, you're taking me back there.
That's why I figured you had all your bags,
man. Yeah. You're taking me, and then BDM is taking me to Como. And he's
BDM?
Taking, you know who that is.
BDM.
Big Daddy Bark. Is that what you always call him?
I don't know. I've never called him that.
I thought someone called him that.
When it comes to my brother, he and I might not agree on everything, but I've always had respect for him because he knows what he's doing and he knows how to deal with himself.
Does he? I'm thinking about getting a new camera. Should I? Should I get one of those GoPro cameras?
Why don't you get one of the Google cameras and just put it on like glasses and just record anything?
I should do that. Then I could just like, then
no
I could
one,
just.
No one would ever know you're recording.
All right. Then I could just like take pictures of like girls' asses all day. Right? That'd be just like.
If that's what you want
quick.
To do, I guess.
I could like get a hooker or something and then just record the sex or something, but it'll look like it's like 3D or something.
Hopefully you've never gotten a hooker.
Oh,
you have.
No, I mean, like, I'd probably do it once just to say it.
Why would you ever want to pay for sex and pay to probably catch a disease?
I can use a rubber.
A rubber.
Yeah, condom.
A rubber? Were you born in the 70s?
I can always use a prophylactic or something.
So you'd wanna go to a woman who is just even could care less about you except for what amount of money you have in your wallet.
isn't that what most women are anyway?
No.
I go on a lot of these dating websites and they're all like,
she doesn't ask me how much money's in my wallet until afterwards.
Oh yeah.
I love you too.
No, I mean, I go on a lot of these dating websites.
Don't take this seriously, Michael.
Yeah, I go on a lot of dating websites, and a lot of these women are like, I want a tall man with a beard that, you know, has a good job.
Yeah, because they don't want to have to support the guy. Why should they have to support someone? I mean, they're supporting themselves. Why can't?
Yeah, but a tall man with a beard, I don't know. I'm not allowed to say I want a chick with big tits or something.
Yeah, but that's a tall man with a beard is aesthetic. A chick with tits, big tits is just.
It's almost the same thing.
No, it's not even close to
the same. Wow. And then there's some girls on there. I don't date guys that don't have a good car or something. So now I'm being judged by my mode of transportation, right?
Remember, and this it goes both ways, but girls often say, it's not what the man drives, but it's what drives the man.
I guess.
There you go.
Yeah, but no, they said, I need a man with a car.
Well, I mean, you don't want to be taking the buses to your dates.
Well,
can we go out tonight? No, sorry, the bus is on a Sunday schedule.
Yeah, so, I mean, I'm, you know, it's not about, like, I don't know. I can always just say I'm trying to be green or something.
Really?
You know what that means?
Yes.
When you're trying to save.
Friendly to the earth?
Yeah. Or I could just say I don't drive because I don't want to give my dollars to the terrorists or something.
Why don't you just say you don't want to expand your carbon footprint?
I guess I don't know what that means. I could just say I if they made a solar powered car, then I'd get it or something.
So that just says you're cheap.
I am cheap.
And why are you trying to move out of your apartment?
I don't like that place.
Since when?
I never did.
The only thing you didn't like it was a big mirror in front of you that you.
I don't like the whole neighborhood. It's all white people there.
You know,
and you're
so black.
That's a bad thing.
I'd rather live in like Elmwood or like North Buffalo where I was living.
Well.
Like I mean, the apartment itself is nice. I just don't like South Buffalo.
Well. Bring some other races around.
Scottsville.
That's my style.
Yeah. And are you repping it or something? No, I just don't like the whole South Buffalo area. I just don't like it. It's like there's nothing to do. It's nothing. It's boring.
What did you do when you were on Elmwood or Delaware?
What did I do? I always used to go everywhere.
Where?
There was a Kmart right across the street.
What do you do at Kmart? Is there parties there? Is there social functions?
No, but I'd like to be able to like just walk to Kmart or whatever and buy something. You know, whatever. If I had to go to Kmart, it's right there. Target right down the street. Two GameStops right down the street.
Oh my god.
You know, you got 7-Elevens up the yin yang up over there.
You got a major pizzeria right at your corner.
Yeah, you know what though? There was a lot of pizzerias in North Buffalo, but there was also a lot of other stuff there that I like to go to. Like right across the street, there was the Japanese place, and then across in that plaza, there was the Indian place I liked. Yeah, and, Applebee's down... What? Applebee's down the street. There was Bob. So
basically, all you're saying is that there's not enough restaurants in your neighborhood.
There's not enough restaurants, and there's not enough just stuff to do.
But there's, I mean, Kmart is not an event.
I know it's not, but game, you know, I could go to Kmart and I don't have to sit there and take a bus that only comes once an hour to get a Kmart that's near me.
I wonder what are we still
0.3 miles?
We gotta make a turn soon.
Oh.
What exit?
4 miles.
It's
also 0.2. Look what it says. It says Leroy.
I can't hear it.
47.
47. That's it.
For I-490, Leroy.
Okay. All right, so we're going into... All right, so we're in Leroy.
I don't know if this is the door. Should be, though.
Ooh, wheat. I like the name of this town, Leroy.
What is it named? Yeah.
Cashish?
What is it named after, like some little black boy or something?
$2 even.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. It's named after a little black boy.
Hopefully you're still recording.
Yeah, it is. It is actually.
I'm trying to offend everyone.
Yeah. I'll put it down.
How much is it? Got that perfect. Thank you.
$2. A $2. Oh,
this is where we're gonna see Chili. I think it's the next exit.
Oh, is it? $2 hoe. Are we in Monroe County yet?
What's she saying? 19 miles.
19.3.
No, we're still in Genesee.
Genesee. Are we in Genesee and Doubt?
No. Remember when you used to live in that area?
Yeah, that was awesome. I'd rather live there than South Buffalo. Hey, at least there's action over there.
Yeah, as long as you duck every once in a while, you won't get hit by stray bullet fire.
Yeah.
You could just walk down the street and go to the Botanical Gardens and witness beauty in nature.
Oh, yeah, I guess. Or I could go to Delaware Park and do the same thing.
Or you could go to...
the zoo.
Up the street from the Botanical Gardens and go to the Basilica and witness God in all his excessive...
Yeah. I don't know. That's... I don't know.
You start going to church.
I should start going to, like, a mosque or something.
Nah, real church. We go to this place called the Chapel of Ghouls.
Where is it?
West Amherst. And
I'm not going there.
I'm gonna be auditioning for the band.
Is it you should get into a Christian death metal band. Oh, here's Monroe County.
Here is this,
and it's town of Riga.
Now we're in Monroe. But you should.
Town of Riga. Like Riga Mortis.
What you should do is you should go to because you so faithfully defend against anything religious, you should go to church to hear the other side.
I've heard the other side.
When?
When I hear.
When did you go to church?
I don't go to church all the time.
Ever?
Yeah.
So all the time. But
I went with you, remember?
When did you go to church with me?
A couple years ago. It was just me and you. It was at that church on Main Street near the Wendy's.
I've never been to a church on Main Street.
Yet. It was like near like what is it? Kind of like near Allen, I think. It was, you know, that Wendy's that's on Main Street.
I have never in my life been in a church near.
I don't know if it was on Main Street, but I know there was a Wendy's.
We did. So you can make a full judgment.
Yeah, of more roadkill.
Entire religious facsimile.
Yeah.
in a 90 minute.
Well, no, because I've read the Bible too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Tell me what the first words of Genesis is.
In the beginning, God created something. I don't know. Created the light.
Death metal.
No, but I know the first in the beginning. I can't. I don't memorize the whole thing, but. But you know everything in the Bible. You know it's weird because it's like they promotes rape. It promotes.
Nowhere in the Bible does it promote.
Yeah, it does.
Lisa is a Bible study. Lisa doesn't promote rape.
No. I'll pull it up where it says where if oh hold on.
If you're gonna use an eye for an eye, that's not promoting rape.
What do you mean by that?
An actual Bible quote.
No. There's one that's on there that said. It says that what is it? If if a woman gets raped and they have to pay like 20 pieces of silver and marry the guy has to marry him or something.
How is that promoting rape?
Well. Because they treat it like, and then like everything else, it's like God, you know, kills like about over, I don't know, a billion people in the Bible, and that's a good thing.
Where do you see God killing anyone in the Bible?
In the flood, the great flood, he kills everybody because he didn't like the way they,
No, the great flood was not a killing, the great flood was a test of their adaptability.
No, I don't know, getting like the bears out to kill the kids that were what do you call it? There was these kids that were making fun of this bald guy and then God sent two bears to kill them. Remember that one?
No.
You ever heard that one?
You remember that one?
No.
I'm trying to get a signal so I can look it up. I'm trying to get a signal and I can look it up.
Are you sure you're an actual Bible and not like something from Anton Sebastian LaVey?
No, and also, you know what? The Bible also says you can't have tattoos. Hold on.
No, it doesn't because tattoos didn't exist back when the Bible was written.
Bible doesn't say you can't have tattoos, but the Bible does say that God frowns against people that puts marks on their body that he originally make them with and create them with. Like ear piercing.
Yeah, so...
Facial piercings and tattoos.
But
he doesn't say that you'll be damned to hell for it. He just says that he created your body in a vision.
To be a chapel.
Yes.
Right.
And a reflection.
And you're supposed to keep it wholesome. It's God's body. He created it.
When the Bible was created,
right,
it did not address things like tattoos.
It did. I don't think it said specifically tattoos. It just says...
specifically say tattoos. It said...
Here, I got the Bible verse about the bears.
What's it say?
On, it's called 2 Kings.
Yeah, read it.
2:23-25 or something. I'm trying to pull it up right now.
You read the Bible as it's like absolute English.
You read it.
There's a translation to the Bible.
Hold on, I'm.
It's in Greek. So.
Just like the Bible, in nowhere does the Bible indicate about homosexuality or bisexuality or mixing of the races. But it's people interpreting things about the Bible.
Here it is. From there, Elisha, I don't know if I'm saying that right, went up to Bethel. As he was walking along the road, some boys came out of the town and jeered at him. "Get out of here, Baldy," they said. "Get out of here, Baldy." He turned around, looked at them, and called down a curse on them in the name of the Lord. Then two bears came out of the woods and mauled 42 of the boys, and he went on to Mount Carmel and from there returned to Samaria. I don't know where that is.
Okay, well, there's a couple problems with
Samaria.
That. A couple problems with that. With that. A, it's not God that brought the bears down, it's someone else. It said he called upon God. But it was not God that sent the
curse.
And B, the word bald was not created until the 1950s.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Well, this is a New International Version.
Exactly.
There's a bunch.
So it's an interpretation of what.
I don't know what.
Wait, that's a New International Version.
I think. Yeah, that's what it says.
Okay. right there, I'll tell you straight out.
The new interracial version is like the,
it's like the Cliff Notes.
It's like the A-Track version of,
it's like the Cliff Notes.
Have you ever heard of the Christians that speak in tongues? And they prance around and they dance. And
yeah, that's weird.
Going,
ah, yeah, that's weird. Pentecostals, that's weird.
Blah, 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 and they just start speaking.
Yeah, what about them?
That's where that Bible comes from.
All right. It's all
in the Bible, it says that God says many books, many versions of his word will be put out there. And a lot of them will be put out there to trick.
Okay. So how do we know which one's the right one?
Into believing what mankind and the devil would like you to believe versus the true word
across,
of God.
Across the world of,
it's called temptation.
Of Christianity and just basic Bibleism, there's one respected version of the Bible.
And which is what?
The King James Version.
King James.
Yeah, I don't know. That was, he wasn't even around back then.
It's like having iced tea interpret your
iced tea. Oh, iced tea to rapper. We missed chili.
We got to be coming up. I've been watching the signs and we haven't come to across it. So
no, I mean,
I would not miss chili for you.
No, King James wasn't around when the Bible was made.
No, but it's its interpretation that is most considered.
Scott will tell you how long I've been going to church for.
I'm not looking
there's
for.
There's only one person that was around when the Bible was great. That's God.
Exactly.
All other versions of the Bible were other people's interpretation of what was written.
Their own.
Oh, what the hell is that? That's a nice looking. I think that was like an eagle or something over there. Huh?
There's a piece of tire on the road.
No, there was like an eagle flying or something.
That's beautiful.
See,
oh, here's chili up here. That's next Sunday. Well, this guy.
They got a thing in their window.
No, I mean, I'm not looking for the one that everybody accepts. I'm looking
but
for the one that's true.
That is what everyone sees as the truth of all the versions. There's 30, 40, maybe 50 versions of interpretations of the Bible.
Yeah.
What the majority of what everyone says is the closest to being the truth. It's the King James Version.
I don't think Catholics read that same one
that's
either.
Exactly
that's
what
exactly
they
that's
do.
Exactly
yep.
The one they. It's the only one they read. So do the Baptists.
Yeah. What you were just talking about.
Especially
new,
your Southern Baptists. They're big on that version.
That new what's that new something?
International Version.
That New International Version is not even a Bible that's used anywhere in the United States.
I don't know where it's used.
It's in like Mishimishi Mahuateri in South
Africa. What? What is it called?
The place is called Mishimishi Mahuateri.
Where's that at?
It's in South Africa.
Is that a real place?
It's an actual real place. Look it up on your phone.
I don't even know how to spell it.
Phoneticize it. I'm sure it will come up.
Mishimishi Mabue.
Mishimishi. James Version of the Bible.
Mishimishi Mabue.
I think that's what the Jehovah's Witnesses read.
Jehovah's have their own version of the Bible.
King James Version.
They don't subscribe to what everyone sees as the actual version of the Bible. They subscribe to their own version of the Bible.
Oh, yeah. Everyone has their own version of the truth.
Not everyone, but the wackos that, like the Jehovah Witnesses and that, those are the people that you have to be scared of because they will turn something that says, you know, like, thou shall not
kill
into, well, thou shalt not kill unless they take the cheese from your pepperoni pizza.
Oh yeah.
They'll manipulate it into what needs to be said.
Well, I mean, yeah, I mean, I'd rather have my own views and whatnot.
But see, you have no view because you don't consider anything. And you say there is no.
There's no what?
You've told me numerous times there is no such thing as God. There's no such thing as religion. There's no such thing.
I didn't say there was anything, no such thing as religion.
Well, what is religion? It's the belief in God.
It's just a faith system.
It's a faith system that believes in not in capital G God, but religion believes in God, be it Buddha, be it Allah. There has to be a supreme being in order for a religion to exist.
Yeah, I know, but
so
I mean,
where is the see? Where we go, it's, they don't say we're Christian. They don't say we're Buddha. We don't, you know, they're nothing. We're a non-denominational church that just reads and believes the Bible as it is, not anyone's interpretation of it.
I don't know. I mean, and I think...
And you get to hear some dudes jam on the stage. Some of the guys on stage can kick freaking ass.
Yeah, but you'd have like a death metal band there. Christian death metal band. They exist.
Not at where I'm at. Oh, there's tons of them, yeah. But not where I'm at. But there's churches that have heavy metal, hard rock bands as their...
You ever hear Mortification? Put on Mortification right now. You would think you'd be listening to Deicide or something.
You ever heard a band called Petra?
No. Wait.
Just as heavy as...
Wait, aren't they from like Canada or something?
They're out of Canada. Yeah,
I think they're
just as heavy. They're just as heavy as Mortification. I've heard of them.
Yeah.
I mean, once you get into a grunt, it doesn't matter what you're saying. You could say ABCs throughout the whole song, and no one's gonna know what you're saying. Chris Barnes singing A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
If he
gets into a guttural roll, you won't know what the hell he's saying.
I do. I mean, like, because if you
read the lyrics as he's saying
them. Yeah, but I can
understand. Listening to him, you don't get it.
You see, I listening to death metal all my life, and, you know, listening to death metal all my life.
How do you spell song?
Song?
S-A-L-M. Yeah. Listening to death metal all my life, I've it kind of like trained my brain to be able to hear them talk.
Do you remember who introduced you to death metal?
You.
Okay, so maybe I might have a little more knowledge or a little more just longevity in doing it than you?
Probably.
So that.
But I'm saying I can understand some of the lyrics.
I played with Chris. I can hear what Chris says.
Yeah.
But there's a point where Chris can go into a growl.
Yeah.
A guttural growl.
I can do it too.
You cannot understand a word he's saying.
Watch, I can do it too.
But what you just did is did a guttural growl in words that don't exist.
I know.
You didn't say anything.
I know.
Chris says words that you can't understand. Actual words.
I mean, did you listen to my rock opera, right?
I did.
And you could hear clearly what I'm saying, though, right?
Because you're not, you know.
Because
you should really stop calling it. There's no music in it.
Yeah, there's guitar in it.
There's
bass.
No guitar. There's you scraping your hands across strings.
There's actually some.
Do you understand what Tommy is? Do you understand?
It tells a story.
Night at the Opera is.
What is it called?
Night at the Opera. Queen.
No, I didn't hear that one.
Those are, I mean...
I have Tommy on vinyl.
Do you understand what 2112 is from Rush?
Yeah.
Those are opera. Those are stories that are told incomplete from start to finish.
Is that what mine does? It tells a story about Clint.
It's just you vocal bantering. There's no story involved. It's just you having a chance to express your discontent of Clint.
Clinton. Yeah. Didn't you hear,
there's
like...
There's no creativity in what you do. You're just saying what you feel.
Didn't you hear, like, the Pink Floyd references in there? I mean, there are some Pink Floyd riffs in there.
There's no riffs. You don't even dare call Pink Floyd riffs in what you do.
I do you ever hear that old Pink Floyd song,
I know all Pink Floyd. Go ahead.
Interstellar Overdrive. There's a song in there where I try to do the riff to that.
You don't even come close to doing it.
It was my interpretation of it.
No, it was. It was your inability to play it.
Oh, what's this?
it's an IMAX.
It's an IMAX, yeah. Is this Rochester here?
Rochester's coming up shortly.
What is this? Batavia?
I think we're in Wiener, New York.
What is it called? Wiener? I think we're in Chile right now.
What was it?
9A? I think
we're... 9A. On the left to merge onto New York 390 north toward Greece.
Greece? Are we going to become Greek?
No, we'll probably turn into Olivia Newton John and John John Travolta.
Greece.
Greece is the one.
Why do they call it Greece? There must be a lot of Greek people here.
You mean where we're going?
Yeah.
There's a lot of Greeks.
Yeah, I know. There's Greek York, yeah. Greek people. They're Greeks. Yeah. Yeah. Is that why they call it that?
Yeah.
I bet you Rome, New York has a lot of Romans in it. Is that right?
Nah. It was just because they called Greece.
Yeah.
That they just wanted to name everything Ithaca, stuff like that.
Oh yeah, yeah. There's a lot of Ithacans.
That old Italian type of.
Yeah. In the Bible and in certain cultures, they call them Romanites.
Romanites?
Yeah.
What about it?
It's people that carry on.
They're Roman.
The left or right answer. Just look up there. The left or right.
Roman shower.
It's heading to the left. It's like a merge.
Oh, don't do that.
You're merging.
What?
Merge?
Don't swerve. Don't do that. Then.
You're gonna merge.
Then.
So it should be coming up right there.
That's right.
Don't do that, or else, Captain Cop will come up to us, and pull you over and say you're drinking or something.
Nah.
And then they could say, hey, yeah, I am. Lemonade, bitch.
That's your merch.
What was that place in Africa called? Sui Sui Bahumi or something?
Not even close.
What was it called again?
Mishi Mishi Mabua Terry.
Alright, I'm looking it up. Do I get a signal in here?
Oh, yeah. It should be like M-I-S-H M-I-S-H M-A-B-O-U.
We should take a trip up there.
Oh yeah, because we can so afford to go to Africa.
Africa.
Yeah, and then we'll definitely have Ebola.
Ebola, huh?
The only good thing that came out of Mission Mission Laboratory?
What?
Answer this one, Lisa.
Is?
Are we from Africa? Out of South Africa?
I don't know.
You got it. You already got it. You got it. Pull it up.
I was going to say Sting.
No.
Mabua Tui Tori. Bua.
Just spell it as best you can.
I'm trying.
Africa.
It didn't even come up. I wrote Mishi Mishi.
Okay, and then put comma Africa.
Hold on. I think I'm spelling it wrong. I think I'm spelling it wrong.
I don't know how to spell it, but it's M-I-S-H-A.
Oh, M-I-S-H? What?
M-I-S-H.
Misha. Is it Misha?
I don't know.
C-H.
No, it's M-I-C-H-A. M-I-C-H-A. M-A. And then just put comma. And then the word Africa, and it should give you the spelling.
Go on. Yeah. I found something that says Wellington, South Africa. The Misha Wine Estate. Mabuit.
See, I can't spell. I don't know how to spell it, but it's because my favorite Victoria's Secret model.
Yeah.
Is from there.
What's her name?
Candace Swainpool.
Hold on, what is it?
Fucking A.
Yeah, I'll find it. Like, I found it. I found Candace Swainpool. She's not even black.
Yeah,
No, she's white. She's not. She's white. South Africa's all white.
It's all white boys. Yeah, she's like... She's like white as the...
Yeah, she's a big...
I'm on her Wikipedia. Maybe it'll tell me how to... it just says South African.
See, when you were learning to poop in diapers,
yeah,
there was something going on in the 80s called apartheid.
Yeah.
And that all happened when all the whites came and took over the peninsula of Africa.
Yeah.
And took over, like, St. John's, all that area, that whole area there, and turned it into one of the richest areas in the world because it's a heavy.
It's like diamonds or something, isn't there?
They got blood diamonds. They got oil. They got so much.
Continue and redraw.
Yeah.
That do I got to do a right or a left?
For Ridge Road, it's got an arrow straight ahead, 600 feet.
All right, I found it. She was raised in Mooi River.
Okay, that's where she was raised, but that's not where she was from.
Born and raised, it says.
That's the only one straight.
Okay. I don't see Mishy.
I'll find it.
I think, I don't know.
Now, part of the area you're talking about where all the blacks are for Africa, that's like deep into South Africa.
You know how Africa's got like a peninsula, like a point to it?
Yeah.
That's where Mishimishi Mabutu is.
Continuing Ridge Road, 3.1 miles.
Yeah. I just got to stop up at the restaurant here to take a wee wee.
A wee wee.
I do too.
Again?
Yes.
Isn't this the place where they yelled at you that one time? That Arby's, we're going back in there. Don't go in there. You don't want
to
go.
Don't take me to Arby's. I'm
purposely peeing in Arby's. You'll walk.
Look, it's B Dubs. It's B Dubs.
What if you come out first and they yell at me again?
Then I'll come back in and pee on their counter.
Can you just punch them instead?
I try to pee on their counter.
Why don't you just pee and
the size of this freaking flag? Holy crap!
Where is it? Oh yeah. Yeah. Well, why don't you just pee inside the
because the hog. I didn't buy shit in there. That's why.
Look at the size of that flag.
If they were nice, I'd buy a curly fry because I am starving.
Yeah, that's a big flag.
Yeah, it is.
It's a big flag.
For a Chevrolet, yeah.
Oh man, my camera is dying.
Smart auto credit.
Is it USB?
What kind of phone you got? Let me see.
Charge.
No, I got an actual camcorder. No, it's plug. It's just like a regular plug.
Oh, it's got a regular 120 plug.
Speaking of cameras, there's Kodak.
No, it's like just like a regular thing you plug into the wall.
This is where your Uncle John made all his money.
Kodak.
That's not Kodak, is it?
Yes, it is.
That's Aaron Pryor.
That's
Kodak buildings in the back.
Yeah. Okay.
This whole, for the next mile or so, is going to be Kodak.
Kodak.
And it goes all the way in. And
2.5 miles,
take exit 9-2-6. Oh, yeah, I see it. Kodak. What do they do there? They just make pictures and stuff?
Anything really that has to do with, Kodak is known for film.
Yeah.
But it's also computer stuff.
Oh, yeah.
It's hard drives. It's anything to do with print.
Yeah.
Maybe I can get a job in there. Okay. You really want to go into the Arby's?
How are you going to get here every day?
I'll just move here. Whoa. My stuff is flying
on. Hanging onto your bag. He's got electronics in the bag. You don't want to be
thrown around.
All right. I thought he was talking about his junk.
Mm. My junk in the trunk. All right, I'm turning this off because I need...
Are you staying in the car or are you coming in?
Are you going? Who's going in?
I have to pee.
I have to go to the bathroom, too.
Do you have to go to the bathroom? Yeah.
No.
You can just hang here, then?
Yeah.
All right. I turned the car.
All right, we're going to Tight Ass Avenue.
Get us on to Tight Ass.
Tight Ass Avenue. Tight Ass.
It should be a left, right?
Tight Ass.
Tight Ass. No, you're rearing to the right.
Okay.
For the 2.5 miles, it says take exit onto St. Paul Street. You're rearing, kind of like this. And then you're making a right onto St. Paul Street. And then in 1.5 miles, you're turning right onto Tight Ass Ave.
Tight Ass. Tight booty ave. Whoa. Don't do that.
Bounce my neck.
You can do it. You could.
That was fun.
Was it?
Normally, you gotta have tickets and go and stand in line.
In front of all the little children.
You should do. You should go up there.
Doghouse.
The doghouse. What's that?
Doghouse.
Oh.
It's a bar and restaurant.
A bar. Mm-hmm. You want to go to Taste Delicious Chinese restaurant after?
Dude, sure. That's because she knows she's really talented. And, because, I mean, there's a few times when they, like,
don't. Yeah, Mike's got his little thing. He comes in every time he sees me. He.
Hey, people. This is Dragon Lord Frodo again. We just went to the House of Guitars. My camera died, sorry. Right now I'm in the bathroom at Jeremiah's Tavern. Charging up my camera in the fucking bathroom. I'm taking a dump right now. Well, we're about to get going from here. I just got done with some garlic parm wings and some pretzels with beer cheese. Good shit. Garlic parm wings, beer cheese, pretzels, yeah. Alright, well, I'm gonna get going. I'm gonna charge this camera some more. Alright, bye.
Yeah.
This way I know what I'm not doing correctly, so when I do it, I know I'm breaking the law.
Oh.
Breaking the law!
Yeah. So that the light up there is illegal, but having your headlights on isn't.
No, because they're not lighting up the interior passage. They're lighting up in front of.
Yep.
I got mine over.
Turn left onto Culver Road.
I was about to say Clinton Road.
I'm sorry, dude.
Turn left onto Clinton Road.
What does that say? Speed humps? What's that sign say right there?
It says hump, speed humps.
I'm taking a picture of it. Oh, where's the window? Where's the window?
There, hang on.
Come on, this window.
Oh.
The back
open
one.
His back window.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, it's unlocked.
Why is the window? I'm going to take a picture.
Speed
humps. I got to take a picture of this. I got to take
MGH.
A picture. No, I don't care. I gotta take a picture of the hump. What is a speed hump? Was that just like a bootleg speed bump? Look. Look, people. Look, it's. Come on. Zoom in. Zoom in on the speed humps. Come on. Why does it have to be blurry? It says speed humps.
Next fourth mile.
20. Yo, can we. Yo, can we go look at the speed humps?
Oh, MPH, miles per hour.
No, to make the turn slow so you can get it.
I'm getting it. I'm getting the speed hump.
Speed humps.
Speed humps.
It's so like the speed bump.
Is that like
speed humps?
Yeah. What does that say?
Speedy's going.
What does that say? Cobb's Hill. Yeah. Like corn on the cob. What lake is that? Like Lake Chautauqua or something? Is that the Chili Lake? The Chili. Welcome to Center City.
That was hilarious.
What? Speed humps?
Yeah.
Why did it say that?
That's got to go up on Facebook.
Why did it say that? Why didn't it just... was it just some idiot?
No, because it's perfect weather. There was no anything cut out or erased.
No.
And there's no way to turn a B into A.
Wow. Why did it say that? Was that say rail station? That's not funny. Watch out for the speed hump.
That window can come up if you're down.
Oh, yeah.
At least a little bit.
It's going to make us like a sonic boom noise if you keep the windows open on the floor.
Oh, yeah. That's what I want. Sonic boom. Mm-hmm.
The sign we just passed under, it said Goodman Street. Goodman Ave.
Goodman. Like yeah. John Goodman.
Only Goodman are there.
Yeah.
Only good men. All the bad men.
Oh, look what's coming up. Look at
Goodman Street.
Look, look what's coming up. It's Clinton Carr Street. Or Clinton...
Clinton Ave, downtown.
Clinton Carr Ave.
Inner Loop.
That's where the ghetto is. We gotta go there. I got tape the ghetto.
Hold on 1 second. I just have to voice Texas.
Come on.
And what the hell are they doing in Rochester with these type of signs?
You gotta send that to me.
What, why don't you... Why couldn't you just, like, type it?
Because it's a lot quicker and I'm kind of driving.
Yeah. You should. Oh, there we go. Clinton Carr Ave.
Wow, here's a Broadway.
My posse's on Broadway.
It says school without. So.
Stone's gonna laugh her ass off at that one.
That's something Baloney Arm would laugh at.
Marshall Street.
Oh, I want to get Clinton Carr at, like, Bill Clinton Carr.
Is that still funny to you?
What, Bill Clinton?
It's South Clinton.
No, I mean, that you're still talking about Clinton Carr, like,
Clinton.
Like 2 years after you got arrested?
We gotta go over the speed humps.
Speed humps is funny, yo. I gotta admit that.
I was on the corner of Speed Hump and Speed Hunt Drive.
Frederick Douglass, wasn't he like a slave? Frederick Douglass.
I was heading toward Clinton on my speed hump. I don't
know. He was like a slave.
Oh, that's pretty light.
You got a phone? Look him up.
Oh, look at the Rochester skyline.
The Hyatt.
The Inner Loop coming up right in front of us.
What is it?
The Inner Loop.
Oh yeah.
The worst devised traffic.
Broad Street.
Yeah,
that's where all the broads
Broad
live.
Broad Street and Plymouth Ave.
That's where all the broads
just
live. That's where all the broads live.
Yeah.
On Broad Ave, a Broad Street.
This thing that starts here, the Inner Loop, is the worst piece of Buffalo.
Yeah.
It's one of the worst devised traffic control devices ever made.
Why do you say that?
Nathaniel.
What is the...
Nathaniel is the name of that building.
What's the Inner Loop?
It's all this stuff where you're going...
It's where everything interchanges together.
This is all one street. It just goes in
intertwines
loops.
Intertwines and
loops. Oh, really?
So you can get to... If you wanted to get to East Rochester, you'd have to go and spin around in a loop and come around underneath this street, above this street, and then back.
Circle back
and
around.
And then back around, and then jet off to the... It's
take a roller coaster ride on
nice.
The highway.
It's we're not going to go through that.
It's dangerous. We're past it.
But what stadium is that? Is that like built?
Child Street, not...
Child?
Child.
What does that say?
Yeah, which stadium is that right there?
It's like...
It's the Wharf.
Oh, okay.
It's called what?
War Memorial.
Oh. What did that say? Child Street?
Yeah. See, that's when they started putting the chili side on, but they were building it, so they had C-H-I-L, and then they put a D instead of an E.
Oh, is that right?
They finally moved the D to E, and then they got chili instead
of... Was that say above us? Amy Street?
Ames.
Oh, Amy Street.
Amy would be a Y. And it would be a girl cutting herself and serving tacos.
What?
If it was Amy Street, it would be a Taco Bell with a girl cutting herself in it.
Oh, you mean Mighty Taco.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Did she be... Would you say cut herself? Oh, yeah, she did do that at my house.
You think Clinton Carr made her cut himself?
I don't know. I think he... I don't know. I think he just cuts the cheese a lot. Oh man, I got 1 minute left. Find something funny for me to tape.
You already got excited with hump
day. That was a hump day.
Speedums.
Water Tower Park.
Let's do the humpty hump.
Do the humpty hump.
The humpty hump.
Put him on the glass.
Put him on the glass. Hump said, knock
that hump his ass.
Oh, here's another ghetto. Oh, I thought that's at Seneca. No, it says Greece.
It's Greece.
It says Greece. We're Greek here.
And Mount Reed Boulevard.
I don't know.
It's a mountain where you learn how to read.
That's what it is. There's the motel. There's the motel.
Motel.
The motel.
Motel.
Motel, motel, burning man.
So if we were to go to Cleveland, we would go where? To like the a motel?
Yeah, probably a Red Roof Hotel or Red Roof Inn, something like that. We wouldn't go to a motel because that's usually lower
that's
quality.
That's the nasty.
Either an
experiences.
Inn,
was it?
Inn or a hotel? It's better.
So we're not gonna go to like you know the Hilton or something.
Well, the Hilton would cost a lot of money, but
Or what, the Four Seasons or
we're
something?
We wouldn't go to one of those little places where it says motel local.
We wouldn't go to like the Bates Vacancy, Motel or something.
Yeah, vacancies with the letters blinking in and out. There's like two cars in a humongous parking lot, that's it.
Yeah. We wouldn't go to like the Bates Motel.
One more dollar because on the way back we need two again. I have $1 in here.
Bates Motel.
Yeah, you still had singles left after the change.
Yeah. That would be cool if we could go to the Bates Motel.
Yeah. So they probably have, was it just like a body in the shower or something? They just keep the body in the shower or something? My
means emerging the traffic.
Sometimes. My battery's flashing on this. I didn't charge it full enough.
So you're going to miss Chili this
I got chili the first time coming up.
You got a little chili.
People, this is Dragon Lord Frodo. Yeah. This is Dragon Lord Frodo. You can't see me because you know I'm in the witness protection program right now.
But you hit those speed humps.
Speed humps. There's so Mark's.
He was humping the speed sign.
There's Mark's Pizzeria.
Because it's so hard to hide him.
No, because look, it's too dark in here, so I just look like a black man in a witness protection photo or something, right?
And you're moving on up.
So I don't know. My battery's about to die, so you won't be able to get chili on the way back. You know, you got your west chili, you got your north chili, and then you got your bowl of chili. So, I know it's pronounced chai-lai.
Train your chili while going over the speed humps.
eating chai-lai while going over the speed humps. Spencerport, Brockport.
And Buffalo.
And Buffalo, and then Lockport. What's everything port around here?
Because Brockport College is out here.
No, but everything over here is like port. It's something port.
New Pope.
You gotta get me those popes.
No, you got a Pope.
A Pope. New Pope. You ever notice all that...
Coming up against the Popo.
You ever notice that the Newport... You ever notice that the Newport's ads, that they all feature like...
0.2 miles. We don't have that shit.
Yeah.
Which is 0.2 miles.
Yeah. You notice all the... You notice... Newport's, all the ads for Newport cigarettes, they all feature rich white people, but guess who really smokes them? Why is that?
Because Newport is a place in Connecticut by the Hamptons that all the white folks...
Oh, is that why they call it that? Then why do the blacks like their men?
Because they think by them smoking their Newport, they can fit in with the...
They're new important people.
The white people.
Oh, is that right? So they're trying to be white, right?
New important people, that's why.
They're trying to be white.
No, they're trying to be the new important people.
I guess. Newports. Where's the airport? Why is everything port?
Why is everything port?
I saw the guy on my polvage.
You know, you got Lockport. Brockport, Spencerport,
Newports,
airports, Portland, Portland, Maine, Portland, Oregon. Everything's port. What? Everything's port around here.
And you're good. You have an opening right behind you.
I'm just gonna name a city USB port.
Ha ha ha.
Ha ha, right?
Yeah. What's USB stand for?
Universal Serial Bus.
What are they talking about buses? Well, there's no buses in computer.
Isn't the motherboard, like those little lines on the motherboard, isn't that called a bus or something?
It's actually the things that hold your memory in place.
No. Not those. I mean, they're like, if you look on the motherboard itself, there's like these little, there's only these little patterns of lines, right?
Those aren't called buses.
What are they? They're like the, what do you call it? The power thing. They, what do they call it?
Chili Santa.
The buses are where you plug in either your memory or your CPU to transfer from data to either RAM or ROM.
Oh, is that right? Yep. Oh, what are those little lines on the motherboard called then? You know what I'm talking about.
Welds.
They're what?
They're called welds, or where they have to solder two connections together.
No, I mean, like, you could see, yeah, like, they're not really white, they're more like wires in, like,
they're kind of, like, printed on.
See, when you see it, that's the back of it.
Yeah.
If you look at the front of it, it's all silver white. Or, depending on what, if it's a data transfer circuit, then it's gold.
It's gold.
An eighth of a cent.
Gold is what transfers data quicker and more efficiently.
Yeah.
Than
it's gold.
Man, we had so much fun today.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, I got to show off my find before my battery runs out.
Which find is that?
No, I mean, what I bought at Hog.
Why don't you do that at your mom's where you got light?
Oh, yeah, yeah, okay.
And you can throw your phone on charge.
Leroy. I wonder who named that one.
Fattest ass, little name down.
I think it was the same guy that named it on the way here.
King Kong.
Oh, was it?
What was that guy's name? Leroy Jenkins or something?
Leroy McNamo.
What'd you say?
He had some Mac and some more.
Hey, what was that one place you kept saying ooey babooey tooey or something?
Oh,
Michigan Mapuita.
What did I say? Ooey booey babooey booey?
Ooey dooey babooey booey?
Michi Michi Babooey Terry. I can't.
I got a little
is this chili? Is this chili?
We already passed it.
It's right there. There's North chili.
Your chili, okay.
Come on, move your head.
That's the welcome.
North and west.
Move
chili.
My head. Where do you want my head to be?
Away from George. Chili.
Duck? There you go.
There we
ducked.
Go. Chili.
Now my next killing me. Don't make me duck too long.
There.
Paul Road.
I wonder if they serve chili in Chi Lai.
Space Center?
I don't know.
I was trying to get the sign there.
Spencer Port, because everything's port in this area. Lockport, you know?
Anal Port.
Yeah, Anal Port.
Newport.
Lockport, Brockport, Spencer Port.
Port.
Newport, cigarettes, airports.
Port.
Portland, Maine, and Portland, Oregon. Assport, yeah.
Passports and humps.
Humps and I got
humps and bumps.
What was that one song? My boom, my bumps, my little bitty humps. What?
My humps. My
oh
humps,
yeah. My There's another chili humps. Sign. Check I missed it. I missed it because it's too dark.
That was
It's
the main.
No, Black Eyed Peas?
Yeah, Black Eyed Peas.
The Black Eyed Peas.
And they came straight out of Newport.
No, they came from Misha Misha Babooey
Terry. There you go. You got it. Way better than me. I screwed it up. What do I call it? Ooey dooey.
I called it ooey. Ooey gooey potato cheesy or something.
I'll find it tonight and I'll send it to you.
That's a fully loaded garbage plate. No offense, but they wasn't kidding. She said they throw everything, including the sink, in there. I got a little bit of ceramic in my mouth.
I bet you. I bet you they actually got it out of the garbage.
What's up, yo?
they dumpster dive for their ingredients, like me. When I dumpster dive at the Imperial Pizza, what does that say?
Mishi Mishi Mabuchi.
Oh God! Get directions.
Yeah, you.
Get directions to there. What do you think's over in me?
Well, hold on, let me try for the Mishi Mishi Mabuatari, Africa.
I'm not sure I understand.
Yes, you do.
Mission, mission, mission. Where are we? The town of Riga?
No, we haven't hit Riga yet.
That's what it said back there. Was that like Riga Mortis or something?
Mortis is coming up.
Riga Mortis.
Takes a little longer for Riga Mortis to set in.
Oh, yeah. That's actually a town, Riga. That's what it said back there. Town of Riga. Yeah, it just said.
I was thinking of becoming a. Going to school and becoming a. Undertaker.
Yeah. What, like the wrestler?
You know, like the person that cuts you open and sticks the fluids in you. And
What do you call that? An embalmer?
No, an actual Undertaker.
Yeah. I thought they just dig the grave or whatever.
No, Undertaker's taking care of.
That's because they were saying Michigan. Mishima. Yeah,
You could be a, what do you call that, a coroner?
Coroner. Oh, yeah. No, coroner examines the body to pronounce it dead.
All right, the autopsier.
An autopsist.
What is it, autopsier?
No, it's an autopsist.
Autopsist.
Oh, now he's talking. We be in Churchville. Hallelujah!
Amen, praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Can I get a hell yeah?
Hell yeah! Ooh,
now I'm enough. Sending that basket over to y'all because the poor people up in
the Wait, we should go. We should take a trip to Christchurch.
You know, Misha, Misha.
Christ.
M-I-C-H-A.
Oh, I was putting Mishy. Right.
Oh, we went back to what you would call it, the map.
We should go to Christchurch someday.
Yeah, just go to Google.
Turn the map.
Christchurch.
Just hold the button. Just push the button.
Wow, my battery is... Wow, it's still going.
Go search, please.
What shall I find for you, Scott?
Scott? What, does she know your name?
Mishi Mishi Mabuatari in Africa.
South Africa.
Search at Google for Mishi Mishi Mabuatari in Africa.
Mabuatari.
Mabuatari. Did you find it?
Charcherville.
What does that say? Black Creek?
It's where all the Neegs hang out.
It's where what? Say that?
All the Neegs hang out.
All the Neegs?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Where's White Creek? Where's White Creek?
Misha Misha Buateri, Africa.
Babuateri.
Okay, I found this on the web for Misha Misha Buateri, Africa.
Oh, I think you found it.
No. Misha Misha, I found a cherry Africa.
This is going to be hard. This is going to be a hard one. What's a what is Mabuatari?
Hang on, I got to read it again. It says, okay, I found this on the web for Misha Misha Mabuatari.
What's it say?
Web search.
Just you gotta say Misha Misha Mabuatari, yep. South Africa. Misha, Misha. Is that anywhere near Johannesburg?
It's close.
Yeah. Is it?
Okay, Misha Misha. Spell the other.
All right, people. This is.
Misha, Misha,
hey, Mabuatari. Where?
What?
Well,
for what? Now I'm taping with my phone. I'm bugging. Bed bugging.
No, because it's water and I have been talking to my body.
do ya? Yeah. That's bugging. Oh. Oh, come on. Oh, shut up. Not you. My, but because...
What's the matter with your phone, Mike?
No, it's because my,
I see the light, but put it on...
Oh, sorry. It's, yeah, okay.
On me because my right eye, that's the eye that's tweaking out right now.
Tweaking.
It doesn't sound like the vertigo, because I can see it through my...
Alright.
It's less than this meter, and it goes directly to my eye.
Alright, well, no, I mean, like, because my cord for the charger, it doesn't go in right. It's, you know, like, I don't know, like... No, I'm fine. I actually think it's on the phone itself, because it has to be sit. It has to sit in a very specific way.
Yeah. My cord that lights up, that's a
speed charger. Is it? It'll
fully charge
the
phone.
It's everything
in your glove box.
Yeah. I'm fine.
Did you
ever
see this cord?
Is that the one that lights up?
Yeah. Oh, you're charging right
there. Yeah. I'm fine. But no, I mean, it's like, I think it's actually the, on the phone, plug on the phone or whatever. So if you move it and it's like trying to, you know, if you have less than 4 or 15% battery in it and it starts going off, it'll start doing that. See, you hear that beep?
Yeah, that's what I was supposed
to say. So it'll keep, because it's trying to keep charging or whatever.
Did you have your phone burned or did you buy it brand new?
Burned?
Yeah.
What do you mean burned?
Sorry. Do you have it flashed?
Oh, no, I got this new.
Okay, we gotta go in. Do you want to come in with us?
No, I'm fine.
The
train. Which train? Oh, did it take you into the jail?
Huh?
Oh, hold on. I don't mind. No, it's the flash.
Oh.
It's so that you can see in the dark.
Oh.
Yeah. So you only have better, right?
Yeah. And it hurt.
I gotta say, you nearly blew out the sewer today.
Did you?
Thank you.
I was backed up to my lungs.
Just like me at the
it
old
was,
country buffet.
It was awesome. It was.
Now, Mike, you got everything?
Yeah, I got everything. Why?
Could you have more?
Because it's normal for you to get there. It's like, oh, I forgot this.
I forgot my buttocks.
My buttocks?
Bridge pass. Well, I pay for it whether we use it or not. I pay $350 a month as a resident of Grand Island.
Do ya?
If I use it or not.
Do you actually fit the maxine for Mike?
Yeah, why?
I'm not running very good.
Proud of you. Uh-huh.
He doesn't fit in mine very well.
Well, your roof line's lower.
You know what's really funny is watching him get in the back to watch drive-in.
Whoa, oh.
Out of dead silence you hear.
Yeah, that's because I hit my head on the
I stood up.
Yeah.
Hard. So I called and they said we didn't need reservations.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Who's calling me?
Good. Yeah, I don't think so. Sunday's a big night.
Well, they're only up until now.
Who's calling me? Oh, my dad's calling me. Hold on.
Somebody forgot.
Yeah?
You forgot your wallet.
Did I?
You got his wallet?
Yep. His wallet.
His wallet? My wallet? Where is it?
It's
in the bathroom.
Well, if you come back, I'll be on the board waiting for you. Let me know.
Tell him to put it in the mailbox.
Put it in the mailbox.
Okay.
Right. Coming now. See?
You know, it's so... Typical of you,
Mike. What?
You don't care about anything.
What do you mean?
I've been telling him, get all your shit together.
I did.
Scoop it all in one spot.
And I think my wallet fell out of my pocket.
Your wallet was sitting on the, I thought it was your dad's wallet. And I was surprised there was money in it.
Was there?
No.
There wasn't money in it?
I don't know.
There should have been $2 in there.
I don't go through your stuff.
Oh. Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
See a wallet, you've got the thing. You
Fair
can
game.
Tell me, you could tell me how many stitches are in the leather.
No, know? I can't. I'm not a thief.
Oh, hold on. I hope he's filming this.
Yeah, I am. I'm not a thief.
Sound familiar? Like Nixon? I am not
a crook.
All right, so what's going on, Artie? Did you see what's going on?
Artie.
What a mess.
Who's Artie Lang?
You know what the problem is? Artie talks like he still has the protection of Stern. He doesn't.
Well, you know what
he's
it is?
He's got to realize that he doesn't.
His problem is he did that on Twitter. Had he done it, like, live and said it on the show himself, in you know, the show, it would have been fine. But the problem is it was taken out of context with Twitter.
Right, but he has nothing, there's nothing, Artie Lang isn't going to save Artie Lang. That's the problem.
No,
he doesn't realize that.
Not at all.
And it's like,
what is he, like a family member now? Like, I don't know.
Artie Lang isn't going to save himself. So,
no.
And without Howard's protection, he's gone.
But for Comedy Central to say, listen,
yeah, I know.
That's too much. You got to remember, Comedy Central's the ones that puts on South Park, who offends everybody.
Right.
He may. So,
what did Artie Lang say?
He was just saying something about some
black woman wanting to make her his slave. And
yeah,
he could be the
slave master and she just, can go free at the end, though.
It's just a disaster. Especially in these times.
Wasn't that part of his one of his acts or something?
Pull it to the mailbox. It's in the mailbox.
Oh.
That's what we use the mailbox for.
Yeah, for
Michael's wallet.
Yeah. Is it in there?
I'm sure it's not.
Is it in there?
I don't.
Mike. What? Relax.
Yeah. Why is it in there?
Because there's change with it.
No. Oh, cool.
Anything else?
Anything else, Mike?
I'm fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
You said you were fine before.
Yeah. Why is it in the evidence bag?
No answer.
Yeah.
What'd you say now?
He's not listening.
Well, why should he?
Look, it's in the evidence bag.
All right.
For the 15th time.
Watch, I'll leave this.
This isn't going to be a good dinner.
It'll be okay.
It'll be okay.
They were there today?
No, they went to,
where?
What was that place they went to? Where'd you go?
House of Guitars.
Oh, he did take you.
Yeah.
He did.
Did you have to pay for the gas?
$15.
$15. What's so funny about that?
But you know what? That's okay.
What are you going to do? You don't have any money.
What's so funny about that?
You know, like you said, it would cost him $40 on Amtrak.
Yeah, it would. What's wrong with that?
There's nothing wrong with it. You split for the gas money. Oh, that's it. I mean, I don't know who you're splitting with, but... Yeah, so that's the thing that got me. You know, Comedy Central has South Park on it. South Park has offended every group.
Right.
And if they can't handle the backlash from that, then it's bad.
Well, there may also be other things going on. You don't know what Artie's doing behind the scenes. They may know something.
Yeah.
So it may be a way to get rid of a salary. Who knows? And let's face it, he's not the drawing once was. So without Howard's show, you know, Howard, he's playing in the Bear's Den now. Where the last time he was here, he played in the main. It's just the way it goes.
Yeah.
You know, he's not going to sell those kind of tickets. And that's just the way it works.
Last time I saw him, he was so messed up.
Yeah. You know, I mean, he's...
He claimed he was sober.
Of course he did. But that's what drug addicts do. They're always...
I said, there's no way he's sober. There's no way. I was standing right next to him, watching him try to sign a book.
Where was this at?
At the casino.
Oh, I don't go there.
We know that. Thanks for screwing up Thanksgiving, Mike.
Hey.
As of last count, I've got like 1,000.
Okay, can we just go to the Hamburg one?
It's getting worse.
Well, just go buy stuff that you don't even want to buy. There's got to be stuff in that gift shop.
Well, there is, but it's
just buy it.
But well, buy me a PS4.
I thought rather than making Thanksgiving dinner, I just take everybody out to dinner at the casino.
But I don't like the casino.
But he's the holdout. He can sit outside in the car.
It's always going to be something one or the other or something like that.
You know, not the game.
Because I don't like that place. I'm sorry.
I don't want to discuss it.
And you don't like hotels because they have fleas, and you don't like
no bed bugs.
Just keep going, Mike. It's always going to be something.
You're always limiting yourself.
No, I just don't like that casino because
I understand. We're not talking about that though. We're talking about bed bugs.
Yeah. And if once you get them, you don't want them again.
That's right.
Actually, I should just stay in a hotel. You know why?
Why? Because
I'm trying to move anyway. So really, it doesn't matter if I get them or not.
But Michael.
What?
I don't know where you got them from. That tenement you were living in.
Yeah.
Tenement.
Well, I mean, they're not. Once they're there. I mean, there's nothing you can do about
it. You can't get
cockroaches and everything in there.
Right.
He had bugs that weren't even, classified.
What did I get, like a Weta bug once?
He had some weird stuff in there. All I know is he's sitting on the phone. I hear him slap, slap. I go, what are you doing? He goes, I'm killing the bugs. I wouldn't even be in there.
Yeah.
It's just a shame that, things happen.
But you know,
can't you use that for? Oh, I was gonna say Scott for Christmas or something, but you already got that figured out. I don't know.
Well, the thing with Scott for Christmas is that, Lisa's been calling me. She's been trying to hit me up for some money.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me!
Let's see where she is.
Well, why can't she hit up Dawn for money?
She's a millionaire.
Oh yeah.
Got a Mercedes and a Escalade.
Does she? I don't know what she. I don't know what she drives.
I said, really?
The ghost.
Yeah, Dave's haunting her.
The ghost with the most.
I said, you know what? People are retarded. That's all I know.
Yeah, but I thought you were being haunted as well.
We are.
No, you're not. Oh look, Oreo is messaging me.
I thought he stopped talking.
Who, Oreo? No. Oreo. I don't know. Some
you know somebody named Oreo.
Some guy in Missouri.
It used to be the when Mike was doing the full Dragon Lord Frodo thing. He was the guy that did most of the comments. Of course most of his stuff started out the same way. You're a fat loser.
Am I?
No, that's what he said.
Oh, yeah.
Is that why he's your friend?
I actually forget what he said. I just remember the name Oreo and that he had a cat named Oreo.
So when his mother calls him to hear from the basement.
That's not his real name, though.
The cat?
Or he's probably a banker.
Exactly.
No, he actually, I don't know. He works at hey, yo, believe it or not, yo. Yo,
stop with that voice.
Oh, yeah.
Use your indoor voice.
Indoor voice.
Yo, that's not gonna fly.
Oh, yeah.
What's that about? Wait, since when do you start talking?
Oh, you know what it is? Nobody's paying attention to
it. It's because I'm...
A conversation here, dimwit.
It's because I'm talking jive.
I'm talking Canadian.
No, this is a YouTube thing.
Oh, just wait for me.
But no, I mean, like, are we going past the casino when we go here? We're not going anywhere near there? So I can't give it the finger on the way there.
No.
Oh man.
No, because you hurt the building so much.
What?
Exactly. You hurt. Can't help yourself. That's the problem.
He's traumatized. He's post-traumatic stress syndrome.
That's what I have too. I have PTSD.
I'm talking over here.
With ADD.
ADHD. Huh?
And
hyperhidrosis. I need to go.
Anahydrosis.
I have to go to a concentration camp. That's where they put all the ADD kids.
They actually put them down in Somalia.
Not a kid.
What? 30. I'm 30. Oh, right. But no, that's where they put all the ADHD people in a concentration camp. You get it? It's called a concentration camp.
I get it, Michael. They gotta concentrate.
Yeah.
They gotta make
something.
These are flashcards
for them. No, when we went up to Rochester yesterday, we passed a town called Bergen.
Yeah.
And I kept saying it's Bergen-Belsen or something.
Who's that?
I don't know, like some concentration camp and like some not like.
What's that one?
It's like Auschwitz, but it's like a different name. Why? What's wrong with that?
You see what he did to this? The lighting at this?
Yeah, I see that. That's your Christmas lighting.
And then,
no, that's year round.
Well, that's your Christmas one, though.
Well, yeah, but there's
awesome.
It looks great.
Have you been down there yet?
Oh, in the Harbor Center?
You don't know what you're missing.
What is it? What is this? Like the inner loop or something? That's what Scott called that. There's like this place in Rochester where you have to like go around this.
It's
whole,
the outer loop, actually,
yeah. It's actually called the bag of, or can of worms.
Right.
I don't know, he said you, in order to get to a certain place, you have to go all around this huge, it's like a roller coaster.
You can't go any. Are you filming this?
Yeah.
It's not going on the internet.
It is not. I will rip the thing out of your bed.
It's not going on the internet or we're never going to eat again. That should work.
That'll
work. All right, so I'm turning it off then. I just want to film myself eating now. Eating now.
Don't film me.
Can I film myself eating?
I would take my teeth out, I swear to God.
Then that'll go on YouTube.
And I'll put them in a glass. Don't be telling me anything.
You're probably lucky.
He's fine.
He's fine.
No, he's fine. I'm only $25. It's only Peter. I was making $150. I was giving her $25.
You should have just kept me going to that psychiatrist that played video games with me.
Oh, yeah, that was a real...
Who is that guy? I'm going to go back to him.
Old
man.
Very old. I'll remember it. Oldfield? Yeah.
Is he still working?
Yeah, he's still working.
All right, I'm going to look him up. I want to go back to him. I want to play... It's therapy.
Where is the therapy?
It's therapeutic. Video games is therapy.
You can't even speak English now. It's all my fault.
Well, because maybe we can play WoW together. World of Warcraft.
Oh, it's a role-playing game.
No. No, you got that wrong. It's not a WoW is not.
She's got this whole thing that comes.
It's an Emperog, okay? It's an MMORPG.
Tell me what that is.
A massively multiplayer online role-playing game. Where you can play with a clan.
Okay.
You can join the clan. No, I know. You join a guild in that one.
Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah. But it's like $20 a month. Is this the huh? Is this from their rock opera?
No.
This isn't from...
Well, you know what it is.
Is this...
Quadrophenia.
Is it?
Second. Yep. Okay.
Yeah. I like Tommy.
Of course you do. Masterpiece.
Tommy's a rock opera, like the Passion of the Jaffa. And ship them back to Sullivan County. Yeah, you know where that is? I think it's like outside of New York City.
Yeah.
It's like the Catskill Mountains or something.
Yeah.
She's like
so
a
why
she's.
Why do you know about it?
Because that's where Brandy is from.
Oh, now I see. It's a rock opera about Brandy.
That's what I tried telling you before.
Oh,
It makes her sick.
Thanks, Mark. Yeah, I don't listen. That's just basically
what I go. I'm also writing. I'm also doing another one. It's not going to be a rock opera. It's just going to be just another CD full of, you know, just once, like singles.
Using the picture of Clint, you got with his big old pork chop sideburns.
What'd you say? Say that.
His big old pork chop sideburns.
Who has pork chop sideburns?
Clint.
Clint has pork chop sideburns.
Yeah, on the picture that you have on your rock opera, yeah.
Yeah, the one I have on that one is me on the cross because I'm Jesus, you know.
Yeah, but then he's down below with his.
He's
Pontius Pilate.
Yeah, he's Pontius Pilate Field. But but yeah, he's like Chris Pontius or something.
Chris Pontius?
Unrelated stuff.
You don't know who that is?
Well, how do you come up with that?
You don't know who that is?
What, I mean, why? Because it sounds like Pontius Pilate?
Isn't it?
Chris Pontius?
You don't know who that is?
I know who it is.
Who?
It's a guy from, Jackass.
Yeah.
But it's just unrelated things, and it's amazing that he can keep it.
Amaze is more like it.
Now, I can draw comparisons to everything.
He's like the six layers to Kevin Bacon.
Wait, what's the name of the band? The Weight? What is this?
It's The Band.
Oh, yeah. It's called The Band because I couldn't think of a real name.
Scott says,
oh yeah, that's probably how they got the name too.
That is how they got.
I have a more original name for my band.
What, the Clint Cars?
No, Dragon Lord Frodo. That's my band.
I hear a lawsuit coming up.
Why? You know, Clint can't even sue me for that.
Why?
Well, because even though it's about him, you know, you gotta think about something else, too.
Oh, here we go.
Taylor Swift made an entire career out of putting down her exes, okay? Why can't I?
Well, because Clint's definitely your ex.
Although.
I mean, but, you know.
Seen each other.
All right. So Taylor Swift makes a career out of putting down people, okay? In her songs. Why can't I?
But she doesn't use their faces.
I don't know what she uses. But I know Carrie Underwood makes physical, violent threats in her music.
How you figure?
If there's a song that she wrote where she goes into graphic detail about beating up her ex husband, I think so.
I think he's right.
And then smashing his vehicle. What?
Oh yeah, before he cheats. That's the
is that
one.
The is that the one?
She takes a Louisville Slugger to both headlights.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. I think that's Carrie Underwood.
Yes, it is.
I mean, if she can make verbal violent threats against people. Why can't I? As long as there's music behind it, you know, then it's art and not a threat.
And you'll be sitting in jail.
Hey, he hasn't had me arrested yet.
Because he doesn't know about it.
He probably does.
If you sent it to him. Did you send him a copy?
No. But it's on the internet. It's like on YouTube. I'm sure he's watching. You know, I have never sold a copy of that. I've only given them away. Of those CDs. I have like 100 of them on eBay. And there's
you have them on eBay?
Yeah, I have the Passion of the Jaffa on eBay. There's like $5. You can buy my rock opera. CD quality, like you're in the place with me, you know.
Well, yeah, I can see why you wanted to do that.
Yeah. It's like I'm right there with you, singing the songs. I write the songs, you know?
What are you, Barry Manilow?
Yeah, I write the songs. Isn't that one of his songs, though?
Yes.
It's called I Write the Songs.
Yes.
I write what songs? You want to run this guy over?
I'll take him instead of you. Michael,
what?
Where's the turn to your?
I'm just gonna go.
I might have to turn off the camera because I don't want people knowing where I live. So.
You mean on?
Don't say it.
I should. I can give directions.
Please, people already know where I live, and you know why. Don't say it because I don't want to tip people off. You know.
Wow, I'm like all dark in this video because I'm like in the witness protection program. Where are we?
Where are we?
Very same place.
I don't know where that is.
Good, leave him off here.
Well, I think I know where we are. Is this Abbott? You know where to go.
Rock and roll. You know where to go.
Yeah.
You know, almost famous.
Is this Elton John?
Don't talk.
Blue jean baby, LA lady, seamstress for the band. Ballerina.
Oh God.
You must have seen her.
The next song up is Rihanna.
Dancing.
No. Are you serious? We don't listen to that song.
Always weary. Tiny dancer in my head.
That's his house.
Jesus reads out in the street.
Oh God.
House is so big. It has four separate furnaces.
I should move in there. How much is he selling it for?
He got nothing for it.
Was his ex-wife living there?
Yep.
I should move in with her.
I'm sure she'd love to have it.
She would love it.
If that's a girl, she's kind of hot, actually. She married again? Slap the handcuffs on me. You're under arrest for you're under arrest for being hot. Guilty of being hot.
Hook your brother up.
I asked Scott if he could hook me up with what's her face's daughter. I was being an idiot that last night.
And you're not now.
No. Is that baloney arm getting a pizza? I hate this neighborhood. Hold Me Closer, Tony Danza. Alright, I gotta shut up the camera. Oh. I have new neighbors.
It's blinds.
Yeah.
I told him, fix those blinds.
It's hard because it gets stuck on the bottom of the
floor. I told you, you gotta stick a scissor to them.
I have new neighbors now.
Oh, yeah. Last time, let's see, you had the lesbians and you had the Russians.
The Bulgarians. Supposed to be a parking lot somewhere. No, now I have this really young couple.
Yeah, what's their problem?
I don't know, but there's like weird noises coming from their apartment all the time.
They're probably having sex.
No, I don't. They probably are. But
I've been missing my stethoscope.
But these people are. I don't know. It sounds like two retards trying to kill each other in there. And it goes on when they're not even home.
Oh, good.
Because they'd leave, and then I'd still hear... They do have a dog, though. Like a little dog. Not like a JP. But it's... He's loud, this dog.
Oh, you can see them, too. In all their glory.
Yeah. All right. I'm turning...
Hey, idiots. This is Dragon Lord Frodo again. What I found that curbside special just now. By the way, I'm back home now. Back from Rochester, back from Niagara Falls. You kiddies want to see what I bought from the hog? I'll show you. I bought two vinyls, so here it goes. Come on, this bag is fucking shit. It fucking just ripped on me, the bag. Maybe it'll help if I flip this around. Alright, you ready? You kiddies ready? Here's the first purchase. Ready? Cannibal Corpse. The Bleeding. Good album. Great album. And I bought this. I know it's not his best album, but it was the only one that they had at the Hog. Dark Throne. I don't even know what the fuck this was. Oh, it's called Hate Them. Hate Them. Oh, this is the one with, what year is this made in? 2003. This one is with the one Fucked Up and Ready to Die. Striving for a Piece of Lucifer. Good shit. Gilv is a good man. But I wish they would have just had fucking Panzerfaust or, what the fuck is the other one? Transylvanian Hunger. Or the other one I like, what the fuck? Under a Funeral Moon. He has a lot of good shit. I can't even... He has so much shit out, I can't even think. Total Death. You know, got the two death metal albums, the first two, I think it is, are cool. I like Panzerfaust, though. Well, that's it. I'm uploading. Ciao.